India is becoming bigger and bigger hub for services space comparing to the manufacturing. Hence, HR is becoming more and more important function in India comparing to other countries which are becoming more and more manufacturing focused. And if you look at all these in four industries, banking, insurance, IT and ITS. So as these industries become bigger, HR is going to get more and more attention. Ultimately, it's about your people. Then is your process. And getting the right people in the business is going to be the differentiator. It is not going to be what kind of technology you have. That all will get commoditized. What will differentiate you is what kind of people you attract. See, there are two types of entrepreneurs in the HR space. One is somebody who's not an HR person, but who sees HR as a business opportunity. And then there are people who are actually HR people, who may be an head of HR in a large company who wants to start something of their own. They look at HR from a very different space. They want to start either a technology company, or most of them actually want to start a leadership training company or a consulting company, because they want to follow their passion. But I don't think so there's enough opportunity now in India when it comes to HR consulting, because that's a space which is already crowded. So if you want to treat HR as a business opportunity, then I think ideas relating to recruitment space are a great opportunity, because somehow there are about 20,000 odd recruitment companies in India. And imagine none of them have gone public, except for Naukri, which is an online recruitment. So that itself speaks for a huge opportunity in the recruitment space. But many of the head of HRs are not excited about that opportunity to go and start their own companies, because recruitment somehow is not considered a fashionable business to be in. It has somehow a lower perception amongst the head of HRs. They want to use it, but they don't want to go and build these businesses. So my feeling is that there is this huge opportunity of bringing technology into recruitment, social recruiting, for example. I'm very bullish on technology recruitment space.
So do you see companies investing enough time in R&D, in HR?
The challenge is in India, not just HR, I mean. In India, no, very few businesses are spending money in R&D. You can spend money in R&D when your business model is strong and you're putting money back in your businesses. Mm. Now, the challenge in Indian environment is most of the HR entrepreneurs are running companies between 2 to 5 crores. Yeah, and they are happy taking out, let's say, a crore worth of profits back home and buying houses, rather than putting that money every year back in to produce a better business for the next year. R&D probably will start when entrepreneurs will start thinking scale. As they start thinking scale, they will have boards. The boards will ask, what is the innovation you're doing? And I think that will make them think differently. R&D will come after entrepreneurs start learning scale. Building scale means building left-brain systems. Left-brain system means using computers. And whether you are using an IBM or I'm using an IBM, we are using the same software. That will get commoditized. It's the people side which cannot be commoditized. The way you deal with people is going to be different from another person dealing with people. And I think the future belongs to people who are much more higher emotionally intelligent, much more right brain in mind. My sense is that as these industries which are services driven or hybrid become larger and larger, CEOs will realize that they need to hire better. They need to have better talent strategies. As CEOs recognize that they need to have better strategies to attract talent, the role of head of HR is going to get more and more important. So, and head of HR has to understand technology. He has to understand social media. He has to understand LinkedIn and Twitter.
How do you see the role of the institutions like the HR Fund in the next 3 years to actually change the fabric of the ecosystem?
We are doing different is we are building A, scalable companies. We are not building mom and pops. B, we are building companies which are highly focused on innovation and R&D. So that's another differentiator that we are bringing to the market. Third differentiator is we are trying to build companies which are truly democratic capitalists. This is where you differentiate. The producers of the movie is different from the directors. So board of directors are like your directors, producers are like your promoters, and your management team is like your actors. When you differentiate, each of them have a different role to play. Yeah. So I think HR Fund is going to create more and more of these firms which are democratic capitalists, where there is a healthy discussion going on between the board and the management team and the promoters. And with this kind of a formula, I think we'll be able to build large scalable companies and which can go public. I mean, my hope is that some of our companies that we are investing in will go public. If we build strong HR services companies, HR heads will be able to outsource a lot of mundane work, non-strategic work to these HR services providers. If you see in US, the HR services industry, by going public, has provided HR heads opportunity to outsource a lot of work. And they can focus on the strategic, and hence the head of HR is able to go and sit on the board and not get bogged down by the transactional work which an HR department might ask him to do. So I think that's how we will indirectly change the market space, by building scalable HR services companies who will allow the head of HR to go and have board positions. And when a head of HR has a board position, he will be able to influence the thinking of the CEO, and they'll be able to attract better talent, more entrepreneurial talent. Because one of the challenges that I feel that a lot of kids that come out of school are very entrepreneurial. We somehow kill their entrepreneurial tendency by making them a lot more left brain, by making them listen to the system and taking the rebellion away from them. So I'm hoping that HR front creates more and more rebellious people, yeah, and more entrepreneurial talent.